Hello friends, just a week ago I shared with you that my sun challenges were on their way to get worse because the trees across had grown so tall over the years and I had lost around 2.5 hours of sun because of this. On 5th of August 2020, around 3 p.m., 5 trees in the garden across fell due to torrential rains and extremely windy conditions. These were trees right across from us and fell due to the extremely strong crosswinds or some kind of force that developed from the gap between the buildings on the left. Because we noted that these were the only trees that fell and the trees ahead didn't fall. Neither did any of the trees on our west facing side have any damage because they were protected by our building itself. South Mumbai received almost 300 millimeters of rain in 12 hours, the highest ever in the last 46 years. 111 trees were lost just in South Mumbai as per the authorities. I could not film the storm as the winds and the rains were coming onto our south facing balconies. I was just able to get this very short clip after the tree fell. Here is a footage of a coconut tree close to our locality swaying wildly to give you an idea of how strong the wind was. Full credit to the person who filmed this and circulated it. In the last video, many of you suggested that we call the authorities to trim back the trees to increase our sun exposure, but somehow that did not feel right. However, looking at the massive losses we had, we should have probably looked at it in a different way. To trim back the trees to prevent the loss of the tree, not to increase the sun exposure in my balcony. And this wisdom always comes in hindsight. It is a lesson learnt for everyone to prune back the trees just before the monsoons so that such losses can be prevented. Around an hour before the trees fell, it was like a storm we hadn't seen before, and we discussed at home that we should ask the building authorities to trim back the trees to half their size. And in no time, one by one, we heard those trees snapping and getting uprooted and falling all over. My problem of limited sun is solved now, but it is really a bittersweet moment for us. Luckily, the garden across extends way beyond what the eye can see. It's almost an acre, so there are still lots of trees, and luckily the habitat for the birds and the small animals that reside there, the stingless bees, all the birds that I shared with you in a previous video, that remains.